our Wobblers classroom. As you notice, there are not nearly as many cribs as there were in the previous classroom. The reason for that is we start to transition the children so that they can nap on cots. So those children that are under a year old typically are still sleeping in the cribs, but as they become closer to a year old, my teachers will transition them down to the cots for sleeping. Now, some of our friends in this room are crawling, some are walking, some are eating baby food, whereas others are eating table food. Some are using sippy cups, whereas others are still using bottles. Some are drinking formula, whereas others have transitioned over to milk. And my teachers will have to design both of their curriculum as well as everything that they're doing with the children based on these children's developmental needs. Once the children have gotten to the point, though, where they are running full bore, climbing on things, drinking exclusively from sippy cups here, then these children will transition into our next room, which is our toddler class. So it's music day. Good morning. So in this classroom, in our toddler classroom, as you notice now, there are no more cribs at all. And the reason for that is we have now started to set our classroom up into learning centers. We have our art area, music area, housekeeping area, our blocks, circle time, our manipulatives, and our library. Now we actually do start toilet training at this age. So as the children will wake up from nap, we'll take them two at a time, make it a social event. If they have a success, it's a big deal. If they don't, it's no big deal. Either way, they get to get up on the step stools and wash their hands. In all of our classrooms, we do have a parent information board where we're gonna have our daily schedules, our lesson plans, the calendar for the month, and then the weekly parent connection. So from the time the children are in the toddler classroom on, we no longer serve food in the classroom. All meals are served out here in our cafeteria. This teaches the children that there's only certain places where food belongs, as well as it keeps the classroom far cleaner. Therefore, the children are much healthier as we're not having food mixed in with their toys.